Hello, my name's Rory O'Connor, and tonight I'm here at the Pride of Sport Awards 2016, and here is my chat with Jon Culshaw. Hi, John, how are you?
Not bad at all. Not bad at all. Here at the Pride of Sport Awards, and it's a very inspiring evening. It really is. Nothing gets you ready for the stories that you hear on an occasion such as this.
You've just come off stage from the Pride of Sports. What has been your most enjoyable moment from this evening?
Well, it's still unfolding. I think just seeing everybody, you know, coming in here and such heroes. I think mostly
it was a relief because, you know, Judy Murray's here, and you know, Andy is one of my, you know, favourite impersonations, and she's not sort of told me off, and I don't seem to be in trouble. So that's a relief. That's good.
Are you a big fan of sports?
Yes, I mean, mainly for the characters it can bring you, but of course, how could you not be? And a vintage Olympic year like this, and all of the characters that surround it, and all of the changing events, you know, for an impersonator, it keeps you very, very busy indeed.
So obviously we had the Olympics and we did have Andy Murray winning. What's been your biggest highlight of sports this year?
It's amazing watching Usain Bolt. I think he's perhaps, you know, people like him are the closest we get to superheroes. You know, he really is. And, you know, he moves at the speed of light, yet he's so ice cool. And, you know, that juxtaposition makes him absolutely intriguing. And also what he brings out of
the commentators. That was the thing about Michael Johnson, how he sort of makes him commentate even quicker at his most highest velocity. And, you know, I was really happy that Usain Bolt broke my world record, because if you want somebody to break your world record, you want them to be real good.
So, yes, the inspiration that he gives to the commentators as well makes him amazing.
Other than sport, I'd say an even bigger year politically. As an impersonator, how's that been for you? I'd imagine with all the new characters that have come about this year.
It's, yeah, in terms of news, you know, there was the time when you had David Cameron and Nick Clegg, who, you know, they're a little bit bland. You know, they suck the life out of your comedy sketch a little bit. But then there was this quantitative easing. You know, in came Boris Johnson, you know, to higher level there now than was before. Then came Nigel Farage. If you want to know the latest UKIP policy, simply go into the nearest pub and ask the angriest drunk what they think is wrong with the country. Now I'll stand in front of some golden doors with Donald Trump.
Donald Trump, there's another one. There's another one with his hand gestures, and possibly freakishly small jazz hands of Donald Trump. It's going to be great, folks.
Constantly sweeping in, the news changing very fast. Luckily the Dead Ringers writers are so good they can keep up with it and write in real time, almost watching the story as it's unfolding and then writing the sketch based on that. You just hope the news stays still long enough not to scupper the whole show.
Who's been your favourite politician this year to cover?
I think the onset of Trump, really. It's so unlike anything we've experienced before. That sense of political established formality is just out of the window.
And you know, there he is. I'm going to call Vladimir Putin. You know, he's a cool guy. We should hang out. You know, let's get Kim Jong-un and let's hang out at the Playboy Mansion. This is the way to do it. This is the way to get people on side.
You know, who knows what we are going to get, but by Jove, it'll be interesting if we're all still here.
And Newsoids was back this year, which was huge. Is there a new series in the works?
Yes, all being well, there should be one of those next year. But yes, it's different to Spitting Image in the sense that Newsoids is a bit quicker. It's rather like Team America meets Spitting Image. Rather than church gargoyle caricatures, it's the 3D printed puppets and the comedy at the speed of wasp stings, at the speed of social media. So it's written and set for the present era, I think.
And how would you compare that to, I suppose, being on camera to a puppetry?
With the puppets, the voices have to be... The puppets are caricatured, and so the voices have to be caricatured as well. Live action, if you're being... You know, if you're being low sugar, then you can be very steady and, you know, at that sort of level. That would get lost with the puppet Lord Sugar, and so it's much more over here and a bit like that and larger than life, and that's really the difference that you get with the puppet shows and such as Newsoids and Spitting Image.
Have you been watching The Apprentice this year?
Yes, I'm about 3 episodes behind, but they're such a great team. You know, Lord Sugar in the middle there, and the sense of how he relies on Karen Brady and Claude Littner, and yes, they're a very intriguing trilogy of folks to watch.
Are you calling a winner?
Do you know, I'm about 3 weeks out of date with it.
I've already gone.
Yeah, it might be. I'll have to catch up.
Off it, maybe Dave or Trevor will win it, you know. Yeah.
And is there anything else in the TV pipeline that you can let us know about?
Well, I'm doing a live tour next year, a live theatre tour. It's about time I did one of those. That's going to be called The Great British Takeoff, which is a pun I thought I would use. So we're doing a few warm-up shows up until March, and then the proper run later in the year. So very much looking forward to that.
Well, thank you so much for stopping by, and it's been a pleasure to meet you.
Thank you very much indeed. You've been very understanding. Thank you very much.
For more videos just like this, visit youtube.com/RoryO'ConnorTV.